All right, so that bat in your hand, I told a little story about this tape being here, and we're going to do a drill because the phrase now in the game that seems to be running amok would, boy, he stays in the zone a long time.
Right.
Now, I'm sure when that's said, there's somebody sitting at home on their sofa going, what does that mean?
Right.
So
right.
We're going to talk about stays in the zone a long time. Yes. And really, the good hitters do that because that gives you an avenue. We back up here a little bit, and we're going to show this stripe on the plate. When you can catch it in different spots in the strike zone, because pitches are different speed pitches.
Right. Right.
So if your bat can actually get that tape mark there, can get in between these tape marks here and stay in there a long time, that gives you, the hitter, a better chance.
These are the best hitters. The best hitters are laying their barrel in early and keeping it through late, right? I remember having a great conversation with George Brett one time. And I was like, George, what was your hitting philosophy? First of all, I couldn't believe I was talking to George Brett. So that's the first thing. I was like, I'm talking to George Brett one-on-one. But I was like, I said, George, what was your hitting philosophy? And, you know, George Brett was one of the best of all time. He said, Case, I tried to be short to it, into the zone, and stay long through it to make sure that I stayed through the baseball. And I think that's a big thing with guys nowadays. Some of the best hitters, they get in there short, and they stay in there long.
So short to it, long through it.
Yep.
And while I set up here, Case, I'll put down the war club. I would like to say this, because of all this unique situation we've been having, this is my first time this year with Casey flipping balls up to home plate and have him raking. You miss going to the ballpark and seeing games, people? I miss this.
I miss it too, man.
Full lather. So I'm like the hydro, or unlike the hydro, where I was throwing you balls on purpose.
Yes, yes.
I'm trying to throw strikes in the nitro zone.
Yes.
And then we're going to try to film it from up above and make sure that your barrel
is staying through the zone.
So to it and through it.
Yep. To it and through it. I'm right to it. Boom. And through it, right? That was a little around it, but to it. Dude, that was through it right there. See how I get it? Into my front side, keeps my barrel through the zone. Boom, see that right there? So I drive that ball to left center and boom, I'm through it, right? So I get into the zone and then I stay through it and I'm able to drive that ball to left center. If I got into the zone and then got out of it, man, I tell you what, there's a lot of pitches that can beat me.
And this is a good drill to do after we did the high one.
Yes.
Because you were talking about being tall.
Yes.
Right?
Tall down through, yes.
Tall down through, TDT.
Yes, TDT, tall down through,
and
yes.
And it doesn't change just because the location of this pitch changed.
No, it doesn't. And the great thing about this one right here is, you know, hitters are visual. So if I can put a piece of tape down and work this, right, I can really start to understand, okay, I'm going to hit it, and after I hit it, I'm going to stay through it. I'm not just going to get off it, right?
All right, so we're going to do something a little bit later, like on a fastball changeup combination.
Yes.
But I think for this purpose, to try to film it, I know I'm not trying to tell you to pull a ball, but I'm going to throw one a little bit lesser and say, let's pull one, let's hit one up the middle, and let's hit one the other way.
Perfect.
But you're saying, if I get to it and through it, it's really nothing changing a whole lot.
I'm letting the ball dictate where it wants to go. If it's middle in, it wants to go that way. I'm going to catch it a little out front. Down the middle, I can do whatever I want. I can manipulate that in the gaps or back up the middle. Ball's middle away, it wants to go that way, right? So I can manipulate that too. But sometimes I can also snatch that pitch middle away, catch it a little out front, and go to right field.
If you stay on it.
If I stay on it, right. If I stay through it.
If you try to pull the outside pitch, you'll roll over.
I'm in trouble.
But if you stay on it and let it naturally happen, you can do it.
Like George Springer did yesterday. He snatched a couple.
Thank you. So let's do this then. Let's do 9 pitches.
Okay.
And I'm going to do 3. I'm going to try to go outer strike.
Okay.
Not trying to trick you.
Okay.
And we'll see what we do. I'm going to try to do 3 down Broadway.
Okay.
And then I'm going to do 3 down the inner strike.
Perfect.
And see what we can do as far as the barrel goes.
Perfect.
All right. So 9. Here we go. That was a pretty good stripe.
Boom, right to left.
All right. Oh, that's outside. That's terrible by me.
Hey, but I got it, though.
I know, but I don't
like it. Because I'm through
it. All right, 3 down Broadway.
Back up the middle. Boom.
Woo. I was having flashbacks.
Stay behind that screen, Rip.
Oh, I'm good, Meat. I took your best shot and kept going.
I know you did. Oh, there we go.
That was it,
too.
There we
go.
All right, now I'm going to come in with 3.
Okay.
I didn't come in, but I tell you what, that one's going to be gold.
Right. Just catch it out front a little bit, right?
Here we go.
Boom. Launched.
Round tripper. Oh, I jammed. Boom. That's my fault. And now 1-1-1 just to finish it up.
Okay.
1-1-1.
Right
boom,
away.
Boom, boom.
Perfect. Oh, I missed it. Give me another one out there.
You know, that was terrible by me.
That's all right.
That was terrible by me, too. And you got full lather working right now. I can hear it. How do you hit? Oh, geez.
Oh, man, you got me rolling over now.
All right, do me a favor. Step out.
Deep breath. This is what you do, the mental side of the game, Rip.
All right, let's get it back, and we're going to do three. Last three, and it's going to be gold.
Here we go. There we go. There's one. There we go. That's gone. It's still
That's a way to finish right there, Kate.